Kicking off with the number 8 spot is another classic scene from Saw 2. And you gotta just trust us, guys. Saw 2 does not dominate this list, but it does have a couple of the bottom spots of the top 9. And honestly, it's not even because we're super huge fans of it. I do think it's one of the best in the series, but honestly, it just has so many iconic moments that help define all the characters and the franchise as a whole. And I've argued this one in the past. The very first time in the series where we get to sit down and interact with John Kramer as a villain. And one of the things that's always made this scene so special to me is that John Kramer's character, his antagonizing force in a budding horror franchise, the likes of which during the time this movie came out, we had classics like Jason, Freddy, Michael, Ghostface, Chucky, Pinhead, etc. Very few of those iconic horror villains had taken the time, at least at that point, to try to go back and focus on what made the antagonist of the franchise. And the Saw franchise, in its second time out, just bucked that entire trend and focused primarily with a large portion of this movie devoted to its main character trying to understand who he is and why he does what he does. That isn't even talking about the rapid-fire editing cuts that we saw throughout this scene, which established a series filming and editing style of which we still see today in the latter sequels. But before I go any further, I want to give Jacob a chance to talk about this scene and why it really impacted him.
What makes this work so much, guys, is because this is the first time we actually get to see the Jigsaw character interact with somebody else. In the first movie, he's typically laying on the floor and we know of him and his character, but we don't actually get to see him interact with other people that much. And when he does, he's in a cloak that half the time and we couldn't even recognize him. But here, he's full-on Jigsaw. The movie actually starts with him actually getting arrested within the first 10 minutes of the movie, which is interesting because now what are you going to do with the rest of your movie now that you've caught the main villain? Now, at first when I was sitting down in the theater, I didn't even know that this really was Jigsaw because Tubman looks so different as he did with hair than he did in the first movie when he did not have hair. But within 5 minutes, he actually really won me over. At this point, I actually liked the idea of the Jigsaw character, but I never fully understood, you know, who he was or what his motivations were. Well, in this movie right here, in this talk of Eric Matthews, we get everything. And it's all because of the performance of one person to make this work. Tobin Bell. And he just owns it in this scene right here. A cancer patient, wheelchair bound, surrounded by several SWAT team members, and yet, while being caught, he is still the most intimidating person in this room. And that look, when he turns his head towards Donnie Wahlberg, that's the moment I knew, oh my god, this guy is awesome. But the moment itself turns into a battle of wills between Jigsaw and Eric. And we just see how devoted John is to his work and what he believes is right, like an insane killer. We find out more about his character. We actually find out his motivations, why he does what he does, how he got the Jigsaw name, why he was connected to Dr. Lawrence Gordon, and we actually found out why he does what he does. As I said before in previous movies, Saw 1 made me in love with the franchise and the concept of Jigsaw. While Saw 2, and more particularly this moment right here, with John Kramer talking with Eric Matthews, made me fall in love with the Jigsaw character. I'll also give a shout out to Donnie Wahlberg's performance right here. As we see him break down, and he's just a guy trying to find his son. He starts off as the hero of this movie, and we're actually excited to see him catch this guy. But within, throughout this conversation, the roles start to reverse. At the beginning, I was looking forward to him catching this killer, but towards the end of this conversation, you were actually rooting for Jigsaw, and you actually want him to win over Eric. But the most important thing about this scene right here, guys, is Tobin Bell's performance. If Tobin Bell does not deliver and hit home run like he did right here, then we would not have a franchise. And if it wasn't for this interaction right here between Tobin Bell and Donnie Wahlberg, and the interaction of these characters, there would be no Saw.
And jumping just right off of that, another thing I feel like there would not be a Saw franchise if not for this movie, these scenes, and just everything that came together to make Saw 2 a reality, is that Darren Lynn Bousman came to play when it came to Saw 2. One of the things that we've talked about on this channel before is that this sequel came from a script that he created for which they bought the rights to and then rewrote it to be a Saw film. Him and Lee Whannell worked together in order to make this a proper sequel to the original film because they didn't have anything and they needed something in production very quickly. And Darren Lynn Bousman allowed this to happen if he was allowed to direct the movie. And I definitely feel like I have to keep reiterating this to all the Saw fans that I meet, is that while Lee Whannell and James Wan created the franchise, they created the world in which this franchise lives, Darren Lynn Bousman created the style and helped create the characters that we have been trying to emulate ever since Saw 5 came out. When they lost Darren as a director and as a creative force behind the franchise, and they've been trying to emulate it ever since. Whether or not he's going to be able to come back to the ninth film in the franchise and deliver another home run is just something that we don't really know right now, but it does give me, as well as a lot of other people, faith that the next film in the franchise is going to go back to some of the golden days of the series and help rejuvenize the fan base. So guys, that is the number 8 spot for Saw-Tober. Tell us what you think about that in the comment section below.
Oh yes, there will be blood.